Hey, hello everyone. In this video, I will be showing you how to delete data in MongoDB database with the help of Node.js and Postman. Okay, so let's get started. So currently I'm having here a demo code for fetch, put and post operation. Okay, and the schema and DB connection. So I have already done the entire video on this. Okay, so if you want to watch that video, you can just click the card that is appearing on top somewhere. Okay, you can just watch it and continue with this, or if you're fine with them, you can just continue with the delete operation alone. Okay, so now let me just show you a sample demo of how this just a post operation works. Okay, so post operation is like over here. So first let me just start the server. Okay, so it's node, my file name, which is main.js. So it's on port 3000, which means my server has started. So now I'll just go to postman. Okay, the path is slash post. So I'll just go to postman, and I have name, email and ID as the data. So it's slash post over here. So everything is fine, and the ID is 22. Okay, just send it. So in the body over here, I'll be getting posted over there. And if I just now go to MongoDB and the ID is 22, okay. If I just go to MongoDB and if I just refresh it, so I'll be getting 5. At first it was 5, now it is 6, okay. So it's getting added over here. So just a demo, okay. So just a demo of post operation, okay. So now let's jump into our delete operation. So first let me stop the server, okay. And I will just come down, this put, fetch, and here it, delete will come, okay. Just put delete, and I am going to delete with the help of ID. Okay, so I will just come to my MongoDB database. So it is this ID that I am creating and passing, it is not the ID that is auto generated by MongoDB. Okay, I am going to delete with the help of this ID. Okay, so I will just come over here, come to the next line. It is going to be app dot, you'll be having the delete function over here. Just click it, delete, open circular bracket. And the first parameter is going to be the path, okay. So I'll just open single quotes. For me, the path is going to be slash del, okay. Del and colon ID, okay. So this is how it is going to work. I am going to get the ID from the parameter or the URL itself. So let me come over here. So it's going to be, I'll show you a demo, okay. Just an example. It's going to be slash del and let the ID be 1, okay. So this one is being passed as a parameter, okay, and we will cache that parameter and we will delete that particular data having ID 1. Okay, I hope that made sense. And this is fine with the path. Just put a comma, it's going to be function, same thing, request comma response. Just come out of this and open curly bracket. Okay, so as I told you earlier, the first thing what we need to do is we need to get a hold of this ID, cache this ID. Okay, so for that, just come to the next line. So it's going to be let, I will put it as delete ID, okay, delete ID equal to request dot params, okay, it's dot ID, okay. So the reason why I'm putting params is that I am getting the ID from the URL as a parameter, okay. So in case if you are getting the data from the body, body means like this one, okay. In that case, you will be using request dot body, but here I am using parameter, so I'll be going with request dot params dot ID. And the next one is going to be our main function, okay. So here I will be using the find owned and delete function. So for that, first we need to have our model name, okay. So in this case, my model name is mon model, okay, just a mongoose model that we have like defined after defining our schema. So it's going to be mon model. Let me just copy this mon model, okay, come down, and so it's going to be mon model dot find one and delete, okay. It's not find one by ID, it's find one and delete, okay. And just open bracket. So it has also like two parameters, one ID and another is a callback function. So first thing is the ID, okay. So just open another circular bracket to be like really careful over here. So for passing the ID, just put a curly bracket ID colon my ID that is I'm receiving from the parameter, which is del ID, okay, del ID. So this ID name corresponds to the ID that I have passed or created in my database. So if you have some name or email, okay, you need to put name and email over here. It's not this, I'm repeating again, this, it's not this auto generated ID, okay. So after getting the ID over here, you need to just inside this delete function, just put a comma, same thing, it's going to be function, and you need to pass two arguments over here, okay. One is error, another one is let me just put docs, okay, docs or data something, it's absolutely your choice. And come out of it, just put a curly bracket. Okay, so first let me explain this, what is this error. Okay, so this function basically just catches in case of like any error in sending the data to the database, and this docs or data, you can name it data as well, contains the entire data which is getting created. So let's suppose say that we are passing id 3. Okay, so this docs will basically have this JSON, okay, this entire data in JSON. It will just return it for our further use or reference. Okay, that's what this doc is going to return. So first let me just go over here. Okay, I will do response dot send. Okay, this response dot send means that I will be sending any data or information to the postman console. So it will be appearing over here, okay, in this place of this posted. Okay, so I will just do docs. Okay, that's it. I guess we are now good to go, but there are still more like if else conditions to be also applied. I'll just do it within 5 minutes. Okay, first let us just check it, okay, whether it's working or not. So just save it now and just come over here. It's node main.js, it's on port 3000. So now if I just go to my postman and let's suppose say that I'm going to delete this particular data with id 3. Okay, so it has like a name as d and email as d@d.com, some random text over there. So I'll just go over here. So the path should be del, okay, del slash the id. So this path corresponds to this one. I am using del over here, and the id that we are considering is 3. And another important thing, no need of these things. Okay, you can just go to none and you need to change this to delete. Okay, really important. If you just have some other option like get post, it won't even work. Really important thing, like it can't be even identified, this error. Okay, so just change it to delete and just send it. So as you can see here, this is the data. Okay, this is the particular JSON that we're deleting with the help of the id 3. Okay, and now if you can go to the MongoDB database, we will be having this particular data. But if we just refresh it, boom, that particular data with id 3 has vanished. It has been removed from our database. So this works well and good, but there is a problem over here. Okay, so what if I again go here and again I send 3 this itself? Okay, because id 3 has been, we have just now deleted id 3. Okay, but what if I do this, try to do this again? So if we just send it now, I'll be getting nothing. Okay, null as a response, because this particular id, it is in present in our MongoDB database. So we need to also have a condition for that. So let's just go here. So the reason why nothing has been written is because our docs, this docs thing is null. Okay, so let us have like this, if docs equal to null, and just go here and have a else block. Okay, else block, and just come down. Okay, and we will be just putting response dot send wrong id, or you can also put id is in present in the MongoDB database. Okay, it's up to you. So let me just now save it and we have to restart the server. Yeah, it's fine running now. So again I will just go to the postman and again I will send the same id. Okay, I'm sending it now. So as you can see here, I'm getting wrong id. The reason is obvious, that particular id and its data, it is in present in our MongoDB database. And another important thing, you need to also make use of this error. Okay, error is unused. Okay, so it's really important to do error handling as well. So for that, it's really simple. If you need to just pass error inside it, and you can just send something, response dot send, and also send the error directly itself. I will just put some text, okay, error like that. And in the else block, just open curly bracket, and you will be just enclose the entire if else. Okay, just cut it and paste it inside it. Okay, so this is pretty much obvious, because if there is any error, we aren't going to get any docs or any data over here. So it's better to have it inside the else block. So I think now we are good to go. So let me just save it now. I will just stop it and rerun it again. So it's on port 3000 now. So now let's just do for all cases. Okay, so let me do put for 10, it has name as J. So if we just go to postman and just change the ID as 10, we just send it, I'll be getting the data over here. And if I just now go to MongoDB and refresh it, I'll be getting the ID removed. So ID 1, 2, 11 and 22, 10 is in there. And let's suppose say that I will put some other irrelevant ID. Let me put something over here, like this much big number. And if I just send it, I'll be getting wrong ID over there. And let's suppose say for error, okay, for error, I think we need to pass some alphabet, okay, instead of a number. This ID, okay, this ID that we are passing is of type number, I guess. I have defined it as a number in my schema, okay. So I will pass it as some character or an alphabet. So I'm just going to postman, and if I just send it now, I'll be getting error, okay. And let's suppose say the final thing is that if you don't want to send this, the data itself, after deleting that particular ID or the data, you don't want to send the entire data to the, like as a response means, you can just remove this and you can just have a message as deleted. That's absolutely your choice, okay. I will do this as a final thing, okay, just stopping it and rerunning it again, and this time we will delete ID 2, okay. Just put 2 over here and send it. I'll be getting deleted this time instead of the data. So this is delete, okay. And I hope you would have found this video useful, and now you can like literally check everything, okay. You can just check fetch and put and post as well. All are quite similar, okay, like, but they have their own differences, so it's always better to like go through them. I've done an entire video on that. You can just search REST API tutorial, okay, in my channel. So that's it. I hope you would have found this video useful. Do subscribe me and support me for more such tutorials. Thanks for watching.